Chapter 39. They used violet, purple and scarlet yarn in making the stitched vestments for ministering in the sanctuary, and in making the sacred vestments for Aaron, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the ephod of gold with violet, purple and scarlet yarn and finely woven linen. The gold was beaten into thin plates, cut and twisted in braid, to be worked in by a seamster with a violet, purple and scarlet yarn and fine linen. They made the shoulder pieces for it, joined back in front. The waistband on it was of the same workmanship and material as the fabric of the ephod. It was gold with violet, purple and scarlet yarn and finely woven linen, as the Lord commanded Moses. They prepared the carnelians, fixed in gold rosettes, engraved by the art of a seal cutter with the names of the sons of Israel, and fastened them on the shoulders of the ephod as reminders of the sons of Israel, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the breastpiece. It was worked like the ephod by a seamster in gold, with violet, purple and scarlet yarn, and finely woven linen. They made the breastpiece square, folded, a span long and a span wide. They set in it four rows of precious stones, the first row sardine, chrysolite, and green feldspar, the second row purple garnet, lapis lazuli, and jade, the third row turquoise, agate, and jasper, the fourth row topaz, cornelian, and green jasper, all set in gold rosettes. The stones corresponded to the 12 sons of Israel, name by name, each bearing the name of one of the 12 tribes engraved as on a seal. They made for the breastpiece twisted cords of pure gold worked into a rope. They made two gold rosettes and two gold rings, and they fixed the two rings on the two corners of the breastpiece. They fastened the two gold ropes to the two rings at those corners of the breastpiece, and the other ends of the two ropes to the two rosettes, first binding them to the shoulder pieces on the front of the ephod. They made two gold rings and put them at the two corners of the breastpiece on the inner side next to the ephod. They made two gold rings and fixed them on the two shoulder pieces of the ephod, low down and in front, close to its seam above the waistband on the ephod. They bound the breastpiece by its rings to the rings of the ephod with a violet braid just above the waistband on the ephod, so that the breastpiece would not become detached from the ephod. So the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the mantle of the ephod a single piece of woven violet stuff, with a hole in the middle of it which had been a hem round it, with an oversewn edge so that it could not be torn. All round its skirts they made pomegranates of violet, purple and scarlet stuff and finely woven linen. They made bells of pure gold and put them all round the skirts of the mantle between the pomegranates, a bell and a pomegranate alternately the whole way round the skirts of the mantle, to be worn when ministering, as the Lord commanded Moses. They made the tunics of fine linen, woven work for Aaron and his sons, the turban of fine linen, the tall headdresses and their bands all of fine linen, the drawers of finely woven linen, and the sash of finely woven linen, embroidered in violet, purple and scarlet, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made a rosette of pure gold as a symbol of their holy dedication, and inscribed on it as the engraving on a seal, "Holy to the Lord," and they fastened on it a violet braid to fix it on a turban at the top, as the Lord had commanded Moses. Thus all the work of a tabernacle of a tent of the presence was completed, and the Israelites did everything exactly as the Lord had commanded Moses. They brought the tabernacle to Moses, the tent and all its furnishings. its fasteners, planks, bars, posts and sockets, the covering of ribbed skins, and the outer covering of porpoise hides, the veil of the screen, the ark of the tokens and its poles, the cover, the table and its vessels, and the bread of the presence, the pure lampstand with its lamps in a row and all its fittings, and the lamp oil, the gold altar, the anointing oil, the fragrant incense and the screen at the entrance of the tent, the bronze altar, the bronze grating attached to it, its poles and all its furnishings, the basin and its stand, the hangings of the court, its posts and sockets, the screens for the gateway of the court, its cords and pegs, and all the equipment for the service of the tabernacle for the tent of the presence, the stitched vestments for ministering in the sanctuary, that is the sacred vestments for Aaron the priest, and the vestments for his sons when they minister as priests. As the Lord had commanded Moses, so the Israelites carried out the whole work. Moses inspected all the work and saw that they had carried it out according to the command of the Lord, and he blessed them.